Next part, we're going to the coral cave to find the blue gem. We're gonna need Mr. Krabs here. See? For Mr. Krabs, you press R, and if you press L, he'll like mow through tall grass. Here's one, and this is his X. It's more like digging for melody shells. Ah, hate it when that happens. Now, this place, I remember it being a bit tougher and longer than the volcano one, so this place might take a while, like maybe two parts. I let Mr. Krabs land into the button. Oh, and by the way, remember how SpongeBob can throw Patrick long distance while Patrick can throw SpongeBob in the air? Well, Sandy can throw characters up in the air, and Mr. Krabs can throw long distance. And you gotta love it when the characters are just standing there, they just do random animation. Ooh, treasure chest. You just press A and he'll open up, give you some extra melody shells. Like SpongeBob, using Mr. Krabs' combination will only take 3 melody shells, while Sandy, like Patrick, takes up a lot. So make sure you don't waste too much. There are a lot of shacks in each beginning of an area, or in case there's moments you want to switch characters. Sometimes I just don't feel like it, other times if I have to. Mr. Krabs, I just throw you down there. Now stay up there. There we go. I'm so glad I didn't glitch out, because when there was a time I played for this level, there's a glitch that there's no grass and the treasure chest is already open, making me stuck here. I was worried it might happen in this playthrough, but it didn't. So we're in the clear. So we pretty much need to get rid of the grass, and Mr. Krabs will open up these pink treasure chests, which I believe are the ones that bring special objects. The blue ones means melody shells. Nope. You can't climb on these vines just by going near them, but I'm not into climbing. That's another. Now let's go find the last one. Which is right there. Right here, that these characters make some strange sounds when they get hit. It really doesn't sound like their voices at all. here we go. We found four special keys. You just go down in this path. Get rid of you. I would say that Mr. Krabs is also pretty strong as well. Now we put these in the right slots. It's the same symbols of cards. Diamonds, hearts, clubs, spades. Ooh, a pirate ship. I'm gonna need Patrick and Mr. Krabs for this part. Not because of these melody shells, because there's a lot of moments with you need Patrick and Mr. Krabs. This part is annoying. It's got black jellyfish. Now if you climb up there, you'll find an anchor, which is one of the special treasures that will be part of SpongeBob's shell. Let's cut through there. Mr. Krabs will open this box and that will bring out the wheel. Let's spin the wheel, and now open this up. I'm not gonna lie, I kinda expecting the Flying Dutchman to make a cameo appearance here because, well, the ship actually does look like his ship. It's green, and the music is so spooky and ghostly. I mean, look at this! You would think that this interior will look like the Flying Dutchman ship. Not to mention, it's green. Anyways, we have to get rid of these jellyfish. I suggest you use Patrick's special move. Continue on. I'll let Patrick press this button. Oh, it's just a treasure box. It's blue, which means it's nothing important. But now you can see why you need Patrick and Mr. Krabs for this part. There's tall grass and there's stuff that Patrick needs to push through. Oop, we're three. I think I'm gonna need Patrick and Sandy here because we're up to a pretty tough boss. And I think we're getting close to it. Jeez, I thought this is gonna take a while. Yo, but it turns out it's not gonna take so long after all. Ugh, my feet are acting up. See, the blue gem is hidden in the crystal, so we need to destroy the crystal, but Every time we take a hit, it will just sort of activate some stalagmites. You also can't get rid of those jellyfish. Why is it? I don't think it can be any character, but I think it's best if you have Sandy with you because you can use her special move. Because that will bring up a lot of the health of that crystal, but there are times that we need to have enough melody shells because, like I said, combinations will cause the melody shells. But I found a blue jewel! Meanwhile, Plankton is up to something. A special growth potion to mutate a super jellyfish. That might have something to do to Squidward. Well then. Now that we got the two jewels, we can put them in their slots and we're in. But I'm gonna put this in. This is in the next part because sometimes I just like making certain areas equal. So in the next part, we'll be continuing through the passage.